Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over doing levels of detail, both for use in Maya and also for export to the Unreal 4 engine. So let's get started. We can see I've rendered out these different boxes here, and they look relatively the same, but they have a bit different detail within them. Let's take a look. So I have the under display, heads-up display, poly count. I have turned on so we can see that this has 124 triangles, 256, 320, and 412. And so, and when it's rendered out, really where you need the extra polygons is when you get close to an object and you start to see greater differentiation. But from further back, you can use swap out and use transparency maps and bump maps. So, how do we combine these into one object that swaps out based on distance? Well, you want to, first of all, name your objects, with the highest poly count object being, calling it number underscore number one. And then you name the others in sequence. So, I've got one, two, three, and four. Then shift select them, and I'm going to hold down the X key and snap these together and move them just so that they're sitting on top of the grid. Okay, and this is for export into the Unreal Engine. And then once I've got those situated where I want them, I'm going to go under the edit level of detail group. And so now, once I've done that, it generates it guesses and it generates thresholds for levels of detail based on distance. And so let's give it a try in Maya. So as I go back, you can see it swapping out, and then as I come forward, there it goes. You can see the detail popping in. And that's in terms of things to be careful about. Popping in is the issue. In video games, I've often seen this happen, levels of detail pop in. If you do it well, and if you meaning if you do it at the right distance, you don't notice the pop so much. So it probably is useful to do a quick test render of the camera moving in, and then if you need to, you can in Maya, you can change these distances. All right. So now let's export this to the Unreal Engine. So I'm going to select the level of detail group, the top node, and then I'm going to go File, Export Selection, and I'm going to use the FBX exporter. So we'll give this LOD test 3, we'll write over it. The key thing to do when to make sure of when you're exporting is that you want to go into and make sure that you have animation turned on. If that's not turned on, you're not going to get a good export. Well, it's not going to hold the data. So I'm exporting, selected, and hit yes. And so now let's import that into the Unreal Engine. So I've got the Unreal Engine open, and I'm going to choose import. And I've got LOD test 3 open. So one thing that I want to do here is I'm going to, if this is the first time importing an LOD, you need to click here to expand this dialog box. And there's this import mesh LODs. You need to make sure you have that turned on, and I'm just going to click import. And if all goes well, we should have a mesh that generates with some LODs associated. So one thing that happened here is, and they mention this in some of the documentation, which I'm going to show right now for Unreal. So if you want to read the documentation, you can go to this web URL for Unreal 4 in terms of the importing LODs. They do mention sometimes there's some issues with the way that maps are brought in. So I'm going to, but otherwise, other than that, it should be fine. Another thing that's worth mentioning too is the automation of LODs is being done more than ever. In UDK, there was a program called Simpligon, which is automates LODs, and it's not, but it's not 100% integrated Well, it doesn't come in free with Unreal 4, so I'm showing it manually. Anyways, let's go back into Unreal, and so I'm just going to go into the material and just fix this. This is my both spec and opacity mask. So I'm gonna select this, the material, transform this to a masked material, and then drag this into the opacity mask. And so now we should have pretty much a straight up object that will have transparencies all the way through. So let's just go back. You can sort of see a little bit of the swapping happening, but it's doing it, and it's doing a good job of swapping between the different levels of detail. All right, awesome. I guess one last thing to mention. If you double click and you go into the static mesh editor, you can also see the screen size in terms of the distance field resolution scale option. All right, well, that should do it. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.